The design for testability, or the DFT, is a concept that is best known in the fields like integrated circuit design or computer programming. In this video, I would like to emphasize its analogy in mechanical engineering and specifically in systems reliability. The general concept of DFT is to make the design in such a way that it is capable of being efficiently tested. As usual, let's see an example.
A steering assembly of a bus, which was used for a long time, was showing adequate reliability. During a reasonable period after the design life, there was typically one component, a bearing that manifested wear, which would potentially develop into a failure. The design team recognized this bearing to be the weakest link, and since the reliability of it was perfectly okay, they considered it to be a benchmark for the remaining components. They proposed a new, progressive design with considerably better steering dynamics, but also a lower life in the drive links due to thinner composition. The life of the changed components was intended to match the life of the bearing.
From the reliability point of view, the components that form the system should generally be of a balanced and comparable life. Intuitively, it does not make sense to have a component that barely survives the expected duty, side by side another one, which exceeds the life of pyramids and which is a dominant cost contributor. We often hear an analogy of a chain, which can hold as much as its weakest link, which illustrates the idea quite blatantly. Nevertheless, this approach has its limitations and drawbacks. First of all, we need to debunk one myth. When there is a chain, or more precisely a system of serial components, the reliability of it is not the reliability of its weakest link.
The actual combined reliability is much smaller. The popular example fails to account for the variation in the probable life. Suppose we have a chain where all links follow a Weibull distribution with a shape of 2.5. The chain has one link with the scale of 1000 cycles and 99 links with the scale of 3000 cycles. The weakest link has only a third of the life for every probability level. For example, the B10 life is 400 cycles for the weakest link and 1200 cycles for all the rest. However, the B10 for the whole chain will be only about 170 cycles, less than half of the weakest link, with the shape parameter of about 2.4. This is due to the fact that there is quite high probability that there will be at least one link out of the stronger 99 which will have lower life than the one supposedly weak link. This will happen in over 85% of cases.
This was quite an extreme example. Not very often we have a system with 100 components in a serial setup, but it illustrates the point. The problem will be lower when there are fewer components and where the stronger links will be much stronger than the weak one.
Due to this effect, the reliability of the whole steering assembly lowered, but since there was not a prior knowledge about the new track links, it was not possible to estimate how much. The whole assembly would need to be tested. The preliminary analysis suggested that the whole assembly does not have an apparent weak point, and the failure mode that would develop under the current testing method would likely be caused by imprecisions in the method rather than an estimate of the real condition.
It is quite usual to develop the test in a conservative way, so that it is reasonably harsher compared to the real conditions. On the other hand, the harsher test may produce unrealistic early failure modes especially when the design is really balanced or when it has a low overdesign margin.
In this case, the design team backed up and used an older design of the steering assembly to save the cost of developing a whole new reliability test. This was one of the cases which demonstrate that the reliability engineering is mostly suitable for small, gradual improvements of the design, rather than a game changer that contributes to avant-garde ideas. Maybe the new design idea was a good one, but we wouldn't know unless we choose to spend the money in testing.
I have a great respect for design engineers, especially those who take on the burden of advancing the technology. And I feel the injustice when the reliability testing sort of stays in the way of progress.
Mostly we can and should keep up with the progress by finding new ways of efficient testing, but sometimes there is just not the business case that would justify the effort. There will always be a little fight between the progress and the certainty, but after all, no risk, no fun.
Here is a little summary of what one should keep in mind when designing for reliability to mitigate these disadvantages.
Designing a weak link into the system may have actual benefits. We know what to test, the testing can be specific and less expensive. The maintenance people know what to look for. If the weak link is still okay, then the rest of the system is also okay. The higher is the past knowledge about the components to be used in the new design, the more targeted and more efficient will be the testing. The popular chain analogy is only approximate. The real chain is actually weaker than the weakest link. When you design with respect to the weakest link, make sure that it is really much weaker than the rest and that the chain is not very long. The fewer components, the better. The smaller is the margin between the real system reliability and the desired reliability, the more precise and more expensive will the testing need to be.
When designing a new product, it is good not only to focus on the new features, but also to understand how the new features will be reliability tested. The design for testability can generally be summarized too. Make sure that the design is capable of being tested in an efficient way.